For us to be able to plot the prediction grid, we need one more function. This function is called plot prediction grid, and in this case, we provide this to you on the course site. We can now try out different values for k. If you use a small value, you'll see that the boundary between the colors, the so-called decision boundary, is more smooth the larger the value of k. This means that k controls the smoothness of the fit. Let's experiment with this. Let's first generate some synthetic data. In this case, we provide no input argument, so we'll be generated 50 observations from each class. We'll capture the object as predictors and outcomes, and that's our synthetic data. We can try running this. Just to be sure, we can look at the shape of our predictors and the shape of our outcomes. And everything looks good so far. We'll start with a value of k equal 5. We'll provide a file name for our plot. Let's just call this knnsynth5.pdf. We'll then need to provide limits for our plot. For x, we'll go from -3 to 4, and same for y, -3 to 4. And for step size, we'll be using 0.1. We'll then call the function. We'll capture x, x, y, y, and prediction grid. The function name was called make prediction grid. And the inputs that we needed are predictors, outcomes, limits, h, and k. Then finally, we'll call the plot prediction grid. We'll provide xx, yy, prediction grid, and file name as inputs. Let's try running the code. We can then repeat this and rerun the same code for k equal to 50. We'll just make sure to update the file name here as well. Let's then run these three lines of code. We can then look for these plots on our computer. We have the 5 one here, and we'll open the 50 one as well. And we can look at these plots side by side. Looking at the plot here for k equals 50, we can see that the decision boundary is pretty smooth. In contrast, if you look at the plot on the right, where k is equal to 5, you'll see that the shape of the decision boundary is more complicated. It seems that you might be able to find a value of k that maximizes the accuracy of the predictions, but that's somewhat short-sighted. This is because what you really care about is not how well your method performs on the training dataset, the dataset we've used so far, but rather how well it performs on a future dataset you haven't yet seen. It turns out that using a value for k that's too large or too small is not optimal, a phenomenon that is known as the bias variance trade-off. This suggests that some intermediate values of k might be best. We will not talk more about it here, but for this application, using k equal to 5 is a reasonable choice.